các đại nghĩa sĩ Tân Dân Chủ, hỡi các anh chị em máu thịt Việt Nam, chúng ta do dân tộc mà hình thành, vì dân chúng mà đấu tranh. Đứng dậy này, tuy cho đến mãi mãi muôn muôn về sau, là màu mỡ cho đất đai, là kết tụ của tính Việt, là tự hào, là di sản cho con cháu. Tinh và hồn luôn luôn cùng sông núi. Sống thì phải cho lắm liệt, mà thác cũng phải đáng tự hào, bất khuất và hùng anh.
Please welcome Ms. Lando for a brief speech in English.
When there is a need in need have died and dead. Instead, they teach people to become a kind of human who has no spirit, no manhood, no manhood in humanity, and towards faith. Kids are being kidnapped for organ packing. Can you imagine that the driver caused to accident and run away without helmet, wisdom, or more terrible? That if the driver found that the victim was injured, he ran back and ran over again to ensure that the victim was fully dead in the front of the ignorant people passed by. Food was mixed with the chemical stuff and sold to medium blood and poor people to cooking and eating. Liquor is the main reason to put Vietnam in the top list of cancerous countries in the region. I will take me a thousand of days to tell you all about Vietnam. Taking this opportunity, I would like to thank America and its people has opened arms to bear us, who had lost country and did not know where to go, 1975. American love freedom and liberty. We also seek for freedom and liberty for Vietnam. This is a time that American had to tie hands with the provisional government of Vietnam, who is the only legal representative of Vietnam with its strategy and plan to overthrow the Vietnam Communists without war. Today, our president nominated an emissary for Vietnam. He is a lovely American who is willing to represent our country to have diplomatic voice to Mr. Donald Trump's cabinet to display Vietnam Communist for my country and might be in the world. Thank you for your attention. God bless America as well as Vietnam. I really appreciate all of you listen what I say. I want to tell the truth. When I came to United States, I don't have time to go to school. I have to go to work. That's why pronunciation not good. I hope I will do better in future.
Please put your hands together for this special number of the event. I'd like to present the dance I Can Only Imagine. By Mrs. Rhoda Tanherin.
I can only imagine Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees or will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. When that day comes, when I find myself standing inside, I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
So the following is the appointment of the new emissary of the Third Republic of Vietnam Provisional National Government. We would like to invite Honorable Prime Minister Dao Minh Quân and Mr. Frank J. Harry.
Sau đây là lễ bổ nhiệm tân đặc sứ của Đệ Tam Việt Nam Cộng Hòa, Chính phủ Quốc gia Việt Nam lâm thời tại Hoa Kỳ. Chúng tôi trân trọng kính mời Thủ tướng Đào Minh Quân và ông Frank Harry.
Following is the appointment of the new emissary of the Third Republic of Vietnam, Provisional National Government of Vietnam. We would like to respectfully invite Prime Minister Dao Minh Quân and Mr. Frank J. Harry.
Mm-hmm.
Trân trọng kính mời Thủ tướng đọc lệnh bổ nhiệm.
Sincerely invite Prime Minister to read the appointment letter.
I refer to part 3, chapter 4, article 1 of the temporary constitution of the provisional national government of Vietnam, dated 6 June 2009, concerning the structure of the government organization. I refer to the decree number 00106/2018, date June 3, 2018, relates to the nomination of the members of governmental representation or collaboration. Decrees Article 1. The nomination of Mr. Frank G. Herring as emissary of the Provisional National Government of Vietnam to the United States of America. Article number 2, the Provisional National Government of Vietnam is in charge of the application of the present decree. Article number 3, this decision comes into effect at the date of the signature, date June 19, 2018, signed and sealed. This is a soldier without uniform. Thank you very much to join us. Today is June 19, 2018. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished and military members. June 19 is a very important day of remembrance in the history of the South Vietnam people. This was the day of 1965 on which the armed forces of the Republic of Vietnam officially took responsibility for the protection and governance of the South Vietnam people. In memory of Rear Admiral Howard Collins, my brother-in-law, and to commemorate the Republic of Vietnamese and Allied veterans, especially U.S. Navy, POW, MIA, and all the soldiers who have sacrificed themselves for freedom, please stand and take a minute of silence for prayer and meditation at this time. Please sit down. Today, on behalf of the Provisional National Government of Vietnam, we decide to nominate Mr. Frank G. Elring as our emissary to the United States of America. General Douglas MacArthur famously said in his farewell address to the cadets of West Point, "All soldiers never die, they just fade away." The deeds of heroism and self-sacrifice that live on in our memories and in our hearts and minds. Their souls, I would ask to help strengthen us and make us more determined to protect our people against communism, terrorism, and tyranny. The Provisional National Government of Vietnam, the Third Republic of Vietnam, seeks peace, freedom, and democracy for all people, especially the citizens suffering from communist oppression in our homeland. Now is the time for change. Yes. I personally would like to thank those who organized this beautiful event. This event reminds us of the decision and sense of purpose we hold for our South Vietnamese. And I pray that all people will have a freedom, peace, good health, and fortune in the future. I hope you enjoy the meaning and information we share with you today. God bless you all. Thank you very much. And now the time for our emissary to talk.
It's always a logistics issue because I'm so tall. The last 4 days have been quite a whirlwind. I've been from Santa Clara to the deserts of California to the Vietnam War Memorial today in Westminster, and now I'm standing before you. Sometimes I think, Mr. President, I'm going to need a quick change between suits and military uniforms. First, I have some people to recognize before I give my remarks. First of all, this evening we have with us the gentleman who I know is part of another group that I'm very heavily involved in. He served in Vietnam after Saigon fell. He was part of Special Forces, an elite team, Mr. President, that was based in Laos, did incursions into the country many hundreds of miles. We have with us tonight that man. Please stand, Brad, and be recognized. Thank you for your service. There are also others in this room that served during the war in Vietnam with a different patch on their shoulder. Members of the ARVN South Vietnamese Forces, please raise your hand and be recognized. Thank you, sir. Thank you for defending my country. Thank you for your service. Mr. Thomas Gabriel, please stand. Thomas and I came into relationship a few weeks ago. Thomas is a man of God, but he's also fashionably becoming a political and financial advisor to the emissary. Thomas and I are working on something so incredible right now, and it may very well be that we'll be on a plane to Washington very soon. Thank you. I also have another gentleman in the room that definitely bears recognition, Mr. Roy Megatron. Roy and I shared the privilege, even though he was a star in Ride the Thunder. I was a background actor. I got to know this man in a very intimate way. And let me tell you something about Roy. Did you ever see the movie Unbroken? Do you remember the bird? There's the bird. He's a nice guy. Good boy. In that movie, you're a hard guy. Amazing. Roy is now an accomplished actor in several films, right? And Roy, I would venture to say that you might be interested in starring in a film about Tiger. We also have Marlena Martin in the room. Marlena, which please stand. Marlena is an amazing lady. She started an organization called International Women of Achievement. She's the director of that. She was rated the 5th most effective beauty pageant in the country, am I right? And what's amazing is, let me read you the recent awards. Current International Queen, Tracy Nguyen, Miss Vietnam. Miss Kelly Tran, Mrs. Vietnam World. A lady, she's a good person to get to know. Before I begin, honey, would you please stand? I'm not standing there. Without my dear wife In fact, we have a joke between us. The Bible says that there's a crown of righteousness waiting for us in heaven. It's jeweled. And I told her that one of the biggest jewels in your crown of righteousness has etched in it, married to Frank. Last but not least, I have a group of people in the room that I dearly love. We've been together now 5 years. In fact, when my wife and I started a business in New York, Linda, 5 years ago, God laid it on our hearts to start a prayer meeting. And we did. And 5 years later, Kingdom Arise, would you please stand in the room?
Sure, and cared for him. That is compassion.
day occurred, 1975. Saigon fell. President Dao ended up in a communist re-education camp, along with, count them, over 1 million Vietnamese were interred in those camps. And by a miracle of God, he escaped. We won't go into that. It's really amazing how he did it. But then he came out on the boat out of Vietnam with 524 other people, right, Mr. President? In the pitching waves of the South China Sea. And a tanker pulled up, and they disembarked, and someone noticed someone was missing. Sounds to me like Jesus Christ that left the 99 to go after the one, because he climbed down back the side of that boat and made sure everybody was off the boat. He came to this country under the Humanitarian Act, and he prospered, owned several companies. But in 1990, his heart returned to his nation. And in 1991, he was elected Prime Minister of the Third Republic of Vietnam, National Provisional Government of Vietnam. You know, over the past few weeks, that the word's gotten out that I was to be made the emissary of this government, opposition has arisen. And it's come from both sides. It's come from the American, and it's come from the Vietnamese. And I've heard things like, who do you think you are? What qualifies you? You never picked up a weapon and went to war, nor have you ever been to Vietnam. Well, let me say this to you. President Dao does an excellent job representing the interests of the Vietnamese to the Vietnam. That is not my calling. My calling is to represent him to the United States of America. I believe the qualifications are as American. First of all, the gentleman who was from the Department of Justice is along with Lawler with us, I wish he was. I was born in Washington, D.C. in 1952 in Columbia Women's Hospital, where that is known as the hospital of the presidents, states, senators, congressmen, and whatnot. A lot of people say, well, that was the formation of your character being born in a women's hospital. But as I grew up in Washington, D.C., I watched my father serve the United States government as USDA and help electrify farms on the eastern seaboard that put K-rations in the hands of our soldiers that helped win World War II. That's my roots, folks. I know what it is to bike through the back of Fort Myer into Arlington National Cemetery. As a matter of fact, I told General Lamb today that the ground of the Vietnam War Memorial at Westminster is hallowed ground because it represents 58,222 Americans who gave their lives and over 1 million ARVN South Vietnamese soldiers. America is about freedom. America is about the poor, the downtrodden, and the oppressed. Look at our history. That's why we moved thousands of miles, ordnance and men, to come to the defense of Vietnam. And ladies and gentlemen, America's enemy is communism. We are in the same fight. Now let me tell you how Vietnam has touched my life. My first wife was married to a Vietnam veteran who went to Vietnam, served in Vietnam as a combat soldier. came back from Vietnam, found that he had a five-year-old son, and he couldn't handle it. So, through PTSD or other issues, he left his wife, he left his son. I married her, raised that boy until he was age 21. That was the first touch of Vietnam. Fast forward, Roy Megatrend, 2015, Ride the Thunder. I became a background actor. And what I learned that I missed as a baby boomer growing up about what happened in Vietnam could fill volumes. Ride the Thunder had an interesting tagline, getting history right. I think we did it. Right, Roy? During that, I proudly wear a pin that states, Bridging the Gap. Ride the Thunder had an external move of bringing United States veterans who served in Vietnam with ARV and South Vietnamese veterans together after 45 years. We held four events, put hundreds of men back together, and they wept and they cried and they fell into each other's arms. And let me tell you something, that was a miracle. Would you like to know what I believe? I believe I'm already an ambassador of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and His kingdom has no end. I am a Christian, and I am diametrically opposed to communism because it is a godless society. And I stand for freedom and the sovereignty of nations who are being oppressed. I am a businessman, and I believe in free enterprise and the non-encumbrance of personal finance. As a matter of fact, I have the executive director of Freegan. Would you please stand, Steve Crummy? Freegan stands for freedom of global, say it, sir.
Abundance.
Behind the scenes on a payment platform that will be able to transfer money from you to your relatives in Vietnam at no charge. I believe that April 30th, 1975 was both a tragedy for the United States and the Republic of Vietnam, and this was due to a betrayal action on the part of others. I believe that the mission of the government that I will promote will be to effect the reconciliation and the restoration of both the American Vietnamese and their families now under communist tyranny. I believe in President Dao and his ongoing fight for the freedom and the restoration of the sovereignty of the Republic of Vietnam. I believe that the communist regime can be defeated. Exercise of free elections and the reconciliation and restoration that can be exercised by President Dao by being inaugurated as the new president of the Third Republic of Vietnam. Right. In conclusion, in 1971, while attending college, the lottery that could have sent me to Vietnam was conducted, and my lottery number was 121. They stopped at 118. You think I had a sigh of relief? I believe that God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost shield me from that part of my history. Now today, history is here once more, and I will now wear the symbol and military uniform of the President and the Third Republic of Vietnam, National Provisional Government of Vietnam, genuine in my service to the President and this government, and the cause and the vanquishing of oppression to the peoples of the nation of Vietnam. My fondest wish is to one day see the flag of my nation flying along the side of the flag of your nation, high on two standards, flying in free air over your sacred soil. William B. Halsey, the hero of Guadalcanal, had a quote that really impacted my life. He said, "There aren't any great men. There are only just great challenges that ordinary men like you and me are forced by circumstances to meet." I will leave you with this. I stand here today for a free Vietnam.
Thank you, Mr. Frank J. Hill. That was a very beautiful and sincere speech.
Quên thân mình, ngày ngày chung lo việc nước. Một lời thề vì dân chiến đấu, không ngại ngùng vì nước hy sinh cho muôn đời tổ quốc quang vinh. Việt Nam đào minh quân, dân đang chờ ngày vui no ấm, xóa tan bao nỗi lầm than. Việt Nam đào minh quân, xây cơ đồ hồn thiên sông núi, ánh dương lên soi sáng khắp địa cầu.